when you read through the list of Roman technologies they either invented or developed further, it staggers me that the Industrial Revolution didn't start in the Roman era. Welcome to the story of how the Romans invented the steam engine 1500 years before the actual Industrial Revolution, almost. Now, if you've been watching this channel a little while, you know that I have a love of old routes, whether it's an abandoned railway, canal, Roman road, ancient trackway. So whilst I tell you today's story, I'm going to travel along a Roman road north towards an abandoned railway. In actual fact, let's have a look at an old map back at base and I'll show you the exact route I'm taking. That we're going to need one of these 157 OS map Marlborough and Savernake Forest. Got a map.
Okay, Paul, that's better.
Okay, so today's journey is going to take us along a Roman road towards an abandoned railway because it kind of fits with the whole theme. But before we make that journey, it's important that we have a quick look at this week's sponsor because they make these videos possible.
Mm-hmm, and this week is HelloFresh, and I believe we are currently working on a meal right now.
So Rebecca, what exactly is HelloFresh?
It is a meal-based subscription service where there's a wide variety of meals to choose from, and it gives us genuine flexibility on like a week's worth of meals for the family.
Because we used to kind of basically just like zip down the road every day of the week and go to the Co-op or Tesco's or whatever,
yep.
Spend a bunch of money.
Mm-hmm.
We don't need to now. So all that does save us a whole load of time. And there is a huge variety of meals for you to choose from. If you don't like something, there's going to be a lot else that you do.
Mm-hmm. And you can set up your deliveries to your convenience.
Combine all that with the fact that you're now eating pretty healthy, a well-balanced diet of meals. And that kind of just happens by the fact that you're using HelloFresh.
I love to cook and I love how easy and simple the instructions are on this. Even Paul's managed to learn how to cook as well.
All right. I mean, yeah, okay, that is kind of true, actually. So they do it in such a way that you follow these steps through in a really simple and easy way, so much so that I can follow it through with great ease. So we're saving a bunch of time and we're now having a well-balanced meal that suits us and the entire family.
So if you sign up to HelloFresh using the link in the doobly-doo below and use the discount code PW6025,
you get 60% off of your first order. That's huge.
Mm-hmm.
25% off of the next 8 boxes. Mm-hmm. Genius. Or you could click on the QR code thingy, scan it now, and that'll do the same thing. So when I say the train the Romans invented, almost, I'm not referring to the early horse-drawn tramway. I'm not referring to the more modern diesel or electric train. I'm referring to the steam engine. Now, I'm not showing you much Roman road. I've skipped quite a bit there because there's a long, boring road section. Got a railway and a canal to cross. Then I'll show you, or attempt to show you, some Roman road from this area. Love a cute donkey. Who doesn't, right? Now, we know that steam engines in the their form were, well, first of all, not used to propel things at all. They were used as stationary objects, maybe to do things like pump water. In fact, just across the way there, I can see a big chimney and building, which was Crofton beam engines used to pump water from the lake or reservoir below up back into this here, which is the summit level of the Kennet and Avon Canal. So the fact they were stationary for some time, well, that helps me and gives me a little bit of justification for the word almost in the title of the video, as you'll come to see. So first and foremost, what exactly do you need to build a steam engine? Propelling stuff or not? Now, let's not get into too much detail because there are a few additional extras for safety. Let's just assume the absolute basics which you would build on and evolve. Around 30 to 20 BC, Roman architect and engineer Vitruvius wrote his works, De Architectura. That was almost like a modern day encyclopedia. It contained everything and anything. Now, largely it did focus on architecture and buildings and how to build, but also it contains anything else that seemed to pop into his head. It's a bit like this YouTube channel in some ways. One such passing mention refers to the Elo pile. He describes this as a metal ball filled with water, which is placed above a fire to produce steam, which is forced out of an aperture on top. Now, the key element here is that he doesn't describe any moving parts, and perhaps alludes to the fact that this could be an invention more aligned with understanding weather. Move forward to 62 AD in Alexandria, coined as the Roman Empire's cultural capital, and we have a man named Heron, or Hero, and he's inventing all kinds of weird and wonderful, but not necessarily appreciated things. The vending machine, the automatic door, the wind-powered organ. One thing that goes unnoticed is he invented the world's first steam engine. You see, he took the works of those before him and adapted Vitruvius's Elo pile, added pivot points to the metal ball, and angled the exit points for the steam, and hey presto, the ball would spin as it produced steam. Now I've ventured north into Savanac Forest, a 1,000-year-old ancient woodland here, in a vain attempt to do something that, well, I can never really do on this channel, which is try and show you on camera the agger of a Roman road which still remains today. Largely impossible through the lens of a camera, but we'll give it a go. Come join me this way. Now, like Vitruvius before him, Heron wrote a list of works, what he'd learnt by all of his tinkering and inventing. And book two was entitled Pneumatica, so you can guess that that contained lots of details on steam-powered things, one of which was the Elo pile. Now, this broadly translates as wind ball, but that's about it. There's not really much else in his works other than how to build it. It was almost like it was seen as a toy. But nevertheless, we have the technology there. We know it's there, but we do need a few other key elements first. Now, we know how good the Romans were with water, from baths to underfloor heating to aqueducts. It travelled miles across the country. But if, like me, you might not have been aware that they took this one step further. 3rd century AD, and we have a water-powered stone sawmill in what is now Turkey, referred to as Little Asia. A water wheel doesn't sound too groundbreaking, but what it was attached to in order to power the saw certainly was. This is the Hierapolis sawmill and is the earliest known example of a sawmill powered by water using a crank with a connecting rod to perform a crank sliding mechanism. Right, we're getting close. You might not be able to see it through there on camera yet, but through there is all the hallmarks of a Roman road. In fact, right through there, up through the trees. Again, that's not going to come out on camera, but bear with me. So hopefully that diagram shows you how that crank arm and rod works, and hopefully now you might be able to begin to see a picture forming. If not, bear with, because you certainly will. Now, I thought today would be a great day to show you the Roman roads because the leaves are falling down, but it's not. I can see one right in front of me now, and I'll try and show you a diagram which highlights what I'm looking at. But if I turn the camera around, you're probably going to see nothing because the camera doesn't really show it. Once again, we refer to the Romans' movement of water, not just along a flat aqueduct, but also moving it up and down. The force pump was used by sitting in the water just below its line and was designed to lift and push up a discharge tube by means of pistons working in a pair of cylinders. To date, 25 examples of this Roman technology have been discovered. 25! So we seem to have quite a lot of things in place here, a steam producing ball we have a crank and rod from the mills, and we have pistons from the force pump action. And even within those inventions, we have a lot more useful things too. We have gearing from the mills, and we have a non-return valve in the force pump. It doesn't seem like we're going to need much more, but there is one thing left. Above all, we have a civilization, we have a seemingly ordered one. We have mathematicians, scientists, society. We seem to have a world ready for industrial revolution. We do also have larger industries which would have absolutely benefited from the transport revolution here in Britain in the mid to late 1700s. Mining, fishing, pottery, all kinds of things that would have benefited from that transportation system outside of roads. Did I just say mining? Because yes, they did have carts in their mines, and they did have ruts. I wouldn't call them rails, but they did have ruts for those carts. Now, one last hunt in the forest before we leave here and head further north for the Roman road. And right here you can see the Agger, just slightly raised up by a couple of feet here, untouched for a couple of thousand years. And right now, the trees in the middle, believe it or not, of that slope bank, whatever you want to call it. And you can walk along a 2,000 year old Roman road in Savanac Forest. I've travelled out of Savanac Forest up there on the hill, walked into some rain, but that field there, right there, is one I've wanted to see for years in person. It's just a field, there's nothing there, but it did contain the Roman town of Cutinio. This field here, this contained one of the tax haven, or the tax center for this part of the Roman Empire, because in that field they found the Roman town, and they found hordes and hordes of coins, wheelbarrows, literally wheelbarrows full of Roman coins. Now that is quite the image of a Roman town. Nothing but a field, but sat below the ridge of Savanac Forest, very beautiful setting. So what went wrong? Why did all of these technologies that we seemingly have in the Roman time all sort of link together and kick off this industrial revolution? Well, for that we may well need to look at the actual industrial revolution at that time. Well, there was big change afoot, the movement away from handmade to machine made. Efficiency at the time was absolutely king. We also have huge agricultural productivity, and we have, albeit a poor road network, we do have an increasing, more organized way of moving things around, increased efficiency on river navigation, and of course canals. So we've now solved the biggest issue in movement, and that was getting the goods that were now so abundant and easy to produce to market. And we've arrived here at the start of the end of my journey. I don't know if you can make it out, but I've just walked down a platform. This is Ogborne platform. That'd be the track bed just there, and just up ahead of me is something quite special. So the Roman road itself would have also gone pretty much exactly where the railway did as well. Compare that industrial revolution, or the industrial revolution, to the one that didn't happen 2,000 years ago. You see, it was said that innovation wasn't really rewarded for the Roman citizen. So our poor hero back then, well, he had every potential to facilitate an industrial revolution single-handedly, but he had absolutely no motivation to do so. And here we are, arrived. The Midlands and South Western Junction Railway, lovely new sign. Come and take a look at this. So even if our hero or heron had any inkling of the huge potential of steam power, and I do believe he did have an inkling because of some of the things that he invented, well, there was no reward for him, no real motivation. And I do believe that if someone had said to him, look, we have this problem, how do we overcome it? I do believe that he would have had the solution. And here we are, arrived my final destination of the day, which is Ogbourne Abandoned Railway Station on the Midlands and South Western Junction Railway. And this part takes pretty much the same alignment as the Roman Road here, taking the same journey. I've been Paul, thanks for watching, and a big thanks to HelloFresh for sponsoring today's video.